There is no question that corporate sustainability yields positive environmental and social outcomes for business. However, what about the financial benefits? Well, carbon and energy management actions can provide these too. For example, energy efficiency often results in not only lower electricity usage and greenhouse gas emissions, but also lower operating costs. UnitingCare Queensland is one of Australia's largest suppliers of healthcare services and has had tremendous success in improving its triple bottom line through energy and fuel efficiency measures. In this video, we're joined by Judene Andrews, UnitingCare Queensland Sustainability Manager, to tell us about the company's carbon and energy management program.
So UnitingCare Queensland is one of the largest health and community services providers within Queensland. We provide a range of services across the whole state. We have 15,000 staff and 9,000 volunteers. We operate in over 450 sites and we have four private hospitals. The services we offer are health and community services, such as the four private hospitals that we have, so hospital services, community services, disability services, the Lifeline Crisis Call Centre, our Lifeline Retail stores, as well as our Blue Nursing Community Services and Respite Services. So we're quite a large community service organisation within not only Queensland, but also within Australia. So as far as key drivers go, for the organisation is part of the Uniting Church. The Uniting Church was formed in 1977 and they provided a statement to the nation. Within that statement to the nation, it outlined good stewardship for future generations within the environmental space. In 2012, the Australian government introduced energy efficiency opportunity legislation, which required large energy consuming organisations such as UnitingCare Queensland to reduce its energy consumption. So that was a mandate for this organisation to look at decreasing its environmental footprint as well as its energy consumption within the organisation. Since that time, that legislation has been repealed. It was repealed in 2014, but the organisation has seen the gains from becoming more energy efficient, so that it's seen as a way of reducing our operating costs. And to this day, we still continue on our journey of reducing our energy consumption as well as our carbon emissions across the organisation. UnitingCare Queensland has implemented a range of energy efficiency solutions, ranging from installation of solar PV on one of our Lifeline superstores and warehouses in Cairns, power factor correction as a result of demand management charges that were introduced in July of this year. We've also looked at our HVAC systems, particularly looking at ensuring that our air conditioners are set at 24 degrees across, you know, across the state. Also, we've implemented a range of lighting retrofits for a lot of our larger offices and also our large Lifeline superstores, where we've taken out the old T8 fluorescent lights and installed LED lights. So we see behaviour change as an important part of our energy efficiency management as well. The reason behind that is you can put in as many lights as you want, but if staff don't actually turn the lights off at the end of the day, you're not going to get the savings. So we've encouraged staff through a range of marketing and staff awareness activities. Anything from, we have a newsletter that goes out quarterly, we have a blog site, we have an internet site where people can get information on energy efficiency. We actually have an energy efficiency mascot, Sparky, who you'll see in our office with the posters. We also encourage staff through competitions. Recently for Earth Hour, we went around the office and saw those staff that actually turned off their monitors. The staff that turned off their monitors were rewarded with a pack of Smarties, saying that they were smart because they turned off their monitor. It's only small, but it's a great incentive. So staff behaviour change, I think, is the key when you're looking at trying to raise staff awareness, particularly around reducing carbon emissions and, you know, caring for our planet. But I think one of the main benefits, and you know, in the times of funding's quite tight within the health and community services sector, so every dollar counts. For instance, last year we saved over $108,000 for the organisation through energy efficiency. And it's portrayed that over time, until 2020, we'll be saving over $750,000. So it's quite a large amount of money that we've saved. And that money we can actually reinvest back into delivering services for the most vulnerable people within Queensland. One of our priorities is the development of a sustainable strategic plan to guide our actions moving forward for the next 5 years. We're also looking at reinvigorating and establishing our Go Green champions, whereby we have staff who are interested in participating in our environmental initiatives across the state. Also, we're looking at continuing our rollout of our energy efficiency solutions, such as LED lighting retrofits, as well as identifying those sites that we think will be best for solar across the state.
UnitingCare Queensland's carbon management journey was prompted by the need to comply with legislation. But even after the compliance obligation had ended, the organisation continued to voluntarily measure, manage and report its energy and emissions performance, and still does to this day. Why? Well, by that stage, UnitingCare Queensland had seen the internal benefits of carbon and energy management. And these benefits include cost savings in fuel and electricity, better transparency and stakeholder communication, and an alignment with the organisation's social values.